Hello everyone, welcome to LMNN classes. I am your Wali Sahib. In this video we are going to discuss about a new concept, that is chemiosmotic hypothesis. It was first explained by the scientist Peter Mitchell in the year of 1961. For this work he got Nobel Prize in the year of 1978. So here he got Nobel Prize in the year of 1978 for this work. Then the chemiosmotic hypothesis was confirmed by G. Hind and Andrew Jugendroff in the year of 1963 at Cornell University. So here the chemiosmotic hypothesis was explained by Peter Mitchell in the year of 1961, but it was confirmed by G. Hind and Andrew Jugendroff in the year of 1963 at Cornell University. Right, then the chemiosmotic hypothesis. Here, what is the main concept of chemiosmotic hypothesis? Here, the chemiosmotic hypothesis explained about the actual ATP synthesis. The actual ATP synthesis, which occurs during the photosynthesis and respiration process. Photosynthesis and a respiration process. So here, how does the ATP is synthesized during the photosynthesis as well as here during the respiration process? Then during the photosynthesis process, here the ATP is synthesized by photophosphorylation. ATP synthesized by photophosphorylation, which is occurs in the chloroplast. So here the photophosphorylation is a process in which the ATP molecule is synthesized from the ADP and inorganic phosphate in the presence of light. So here during the photosynthesis process, the ATP is synthesized by the photophosphorylation, which is occurs in the chloroplast. Then during the respiration process, here the ATP is synthesized by the oxidative phosphorylation. By the oxidative phosphorylation, which is occurs in the mitochondria. So here, mitochondria and chloroplast both are semi-autonomously replicating organelles. So here, the semi-autonomous cellular organelles, chloroplast and mitochondria. Here the photophosphorylation is which is occurs in the chloroplast, and oxidative phosphorylation which is occurs in the mitochondria. So here during the photosynthesis process, the ATP is synthesized by the photophosphorylation which is occurs in the chloroplast, as well as here the ATP is synthesized during the respiration process by the oxidative phosphorylation which is occurs in the mitochondria. Right, then here the ATP synthesis which is linked to the proton gradient. So here a development of proton gradient across the membrane. So here the ATP synthesis which is linked to the proton gradient. So here the proton accumulation occurs in the chloroplast and also in the mitochondria. So here where does the proton gradient is created in the chloroplast and mitochondria? So here if we observe the chloroplast, here the proton gradient which is initiated in the lumen of thylakoid. If we observe the thylakoid membrane, here the protons are translocated from stroma into the lumen. So here all H plus ions are highly accumulated in the lumen of thylakoid and created proton gradient. But in the respiration process, or during the respiration process, here the proton gradient which is initiated are created in the perimitochondrial space. Perimitochondrial space or intermembrane space. Perimitochondrial space or intermembrane space. So here, if you observe the diagram of mitochondria, here the proton accumulation which is occurs in the perimitochondrial space or intermitochondrial intermembrane space, which is present in between outer and inner membrane. So here in the mitochondria, the protons are translocated from matrix into the perimitochondrial space. So here the proton accumulation which is occurs in the chloroplast at particularly lumen of the thylakoid, but in the mitochondria the H plus ion concentration or the proton gradient or accumulation of protons which is takes place in the perimitochondrial space or the intermembrane space. Now we are only discussing about here the lumen of thylakoid, the proton gradient which is created in the lumen of the thylakoid. So here if we observe the lumen of the thylakoid which is rich in H plus ions, so here the more amount of H plus ions are if we observe the thylakoid membrane, on the thylakoid membrane there are photosystems and electron carriers located. So here this is the photosystem 2 and this is the photosystem 1 and this is the cytochrome B6F complex. And then in between the photosystem 2 and cytochrome B6 complex, here the plastoquinone and plastoquinol both are present. And then in between the cytochrome B6 complex and PS1, here the plastocyanin is present. So here if we observe the lumen of the thylakoid membrane, so here this is the total empty space of thylakoid is lumen. This is the lumen of thylakoid. So here the proton accumulation which is occurs in the lumen of the thylakoids, here the protons are translocated from stroma into the lumen of the thylakoid when the electrons are transferred from one carrier to another carrier. So during the transportation of electrons from one carrier to another carrier, here the protons are translocated from stroma into the lumen of the thylakoid. So here the protons which are also translocated here into the lumen of thylakoids, and then here the protons which are highly released from the photolysis of water. So here the water molecules which are present in the lumen of thylakoid which are broken down in the presence of light. So here the water molecule releases protons and electrons and oxygen. So here oxygen is a byproduct of photosynthesis which is directly eliminated or enter into the atmosphere. Then the released protons are highly accumulated in the lumen of thylakoid, then which is create the proton gradient. Then here the released electrons from the water molecule and enter into the PS2, photosystem 2. In the photosystem 2, the reaction center is here P680. So here the P680 absorb the light energy, absorb the light energy and goes to excited state, goes to excited state. Then the excited state of PS2 donates electrons to the initial electron acceptor, that is here pheophyton. But in the chemiosmotic hypothesis, the released electrons are not transferred to the initial, the primary electron acceptor, but the electrons are transferred to the hydrogen carrier, that is here plastoquinone. So here we didn't mention any pheophyton which is present in the on the membrane of thylakoid membrane. So here in the chemiosmotic hypothesis, the released electrons from the water molecule enter into the PS2. Then PS2 absorb the certain amount of energy or the sufficient energy from the sunlight and goes to excited state. Then donates its electron to the not initial electron acceptor, it donated its electron to the hydrogen carrier, that is here plastoquinone. Plastoquinone is a hydrogen carrier. So here the electrons are initially donated to the hydrogen carrier, not to the electron carrier, and then the electrons are transferred to the oxidized, plastoquinone, that is plastoquinol. Then the plastoquinol further transfer to the electrons to the cytochrome B6F complex. Here the translocation of hydrogen ions or the H+ ions increases from stroma into the lumen of thylakoid. During the quinone cycle or by the quinone cycle. So here the quinone cycle is nothing but the continuous flow of electrons from plastoquinone to cytochrome B6F complex. So here for the continuous transportation of electrons from plastoquinone to cytochrome B6F complex, here increases the proton translocation from the stroma into the lumen of thylakoid. So here in the stroma the H+ ion concentration is decreased. Low H+ ions occurs in the stroma. And then after the transferring of electrons to the cytochrome B6F ion complex, then it transfer to the electrons plastocyanin. Plastocyanin is a copper containing mobile carrier. So this copper containing mobile carrier further translocate or transport its electron to the PS1. That is here P700 is the reaction center in the PS1, photosystem 1. So here the photosystem absorb sufficient light energy from the sunlight. Here the photosystem 1 absorb the sufficient energy from the sunlight and goes to excited state. Then excited state of PS1 transfer its electrons to the pyridoxine. Then pyridoxine transfer its electron to the NADP+, which is further reduced into the NADH+H+. So here finally the electrons are accepted by NADP+. Here further reduction of NADP+, here the hydrogen ions are also required. So here these hydrogen ions are accepted by hydrogen ions are accepted by the NADP plus from the stroma. So here also same, the low amount of H plus ions. So here finally in the stroma of the chloroplast, the H plus ion concentration is decreases. When the H plus ion concentration decreases, here the pH levels are increased. pH levels are increased. So here, during the transportation of electrons from one carrier to another carrier, here the protons are translocated from stroma into the lumen of the thylakoids through the proton trans channels. Proton channels. And then, if you observe the lumen of the thylakoid, here the proton accumulation is highly occurs. It causes or it creates here the proton gradient. Proton gradient. And then the NADP plus, which is present towards or which is present on the outer surface of thylakoid membrane, present towards stroma. So here this reduction process, which is catalyzed by the NADP reductase enzyme. NADP reductase enzyme. So here the finally the electrons are accepted by the NADP plus and reduced into the NADPH plus H plus. So here further reduction of NADP plus, here the protons are also required. The required protons are obtained from stroma. So here the stroma, in the stroma the hydrogen ion concentration is decreased. When the hydrogen ion concentration decreases, here the pH levels are increased. And then here the increased proton accumulation in the lumen of the thylakoid, which causes the proton gradient. So in the lumen of the thylakoid, here the high H plus ion concentration and decreases pH levels. So here if hydrogen ion concentration increases in the lumen of the thylakoid, then decreases the pH levels. And then the final step of the chemiosmotic hypothesis, here the created proton gradient, which is broken down by the translocation of protons from the lumen of thylakoid into the stroma through the proton channel, which is located in the ATP synthase enzyme, which is located in the ATP synthase enzyme. So here this is the ATP synthase enzyme, which consists of two components. They are CF0 and CF1. Component CF0 and component CF1. So here these are the two components which are present in the ATP synthase. So here CF0 is, here the CF0 is located in the membrane of thylakoid. So here it is a integral membrane protein. Integral membrane protein, which is embedded within the thylakoid membrane. So here, which is a integral membrane protein, and it is a lipophilic in nature. Lipophilic in nature, freely moving in the lipid bilayer. And then here the CF0, which is acts as here the proton channel for translocation of protons from lumen of the thylakoids into the stroma. So here the lumen of the thylakoids, here the translocation of protons from the lumen of the thylakoids into the stroma through the proton channel, which is located in the thylakoid membrane of the ATP synthase. So here the CF0 is here the integral membrane protein, and which is a lipophilic in nature and acts as a proton channel. So here the protons are translocated from CF0 by the facilitated diffusion, by the facilitated diffusion. Facilitated diffusion. Here the protons are translocated from lumen of the thylakoids into the stroma. So here the proton translocation which is occurs through the CFNAT, that is integral membrane protein or component of ATP synthase. And then here the proton gradient is broken down when the protons are translocated from lumen of the thylakoid into the stroma. So during that time certain amount of energy is released, that is here PMF, proton motive force. Certain amount of energy is released during the translocation of protons from lumen of the thylakoid into the stroma. So here the proton gradient is broken down and releases certain amount of energy. This energy which causes conformational changes in the CF1, which is a component of the ATP synthese. So here some conformational changes which occurs in the CF1, it gets the catalytic activity, that is here ATPase catalytic activity, and further it involved in the synthesis of ATP molecule from the ADP and inorganic phosphate. ADP and inorganic phosphate. So here finally the ATP molecule is synthesized in the stroma. So here the ATP molecules which are synthesized in the stroma from the ADP and inorganic phosphate by the ATP synthase. ATP synthase. So here this is the enzyme catalyzed reaction. So during the photophosphorylation reaction, here the ATP molecule is synthesized from the ATP and inorganic phosphate by the ATP synthase. So here the proton gradient which is broken down and releases certain amount of energy, that is here the PMF, that is proton motive force, which causes conformational changes in the CF1, component F1. Here, after the conformational changes of CF1, it gets catalytic activity, or it has the catalytic activity which is further involved in the synthesis of ATP molecule from the ADP and inorganic phosphate. And then finally the ATP molecule is synthesized in the stroma. So here the NADPH molecule and the ATP molecule, both are synthesized in the chemiosmotic hypothesis. And then what are the components which are required for the chemiosmotic hypothesis? So here for the chemiosmotic hypothesis, the requirements are here a membrane, that is the thylakoid membrane, and proton pump which has the ability to translocate the protons from lumen of the thylakoid into the stroma, and then proton gradient and ATPase enzyme or ATP synthase enzyme. These are the four important requirements for the chemiosmotic hypothesis. So here in the chemiosmotic hypothesis, the synthesized ATP molecules are further used in the carbon reduction process, as well as which are also used in the biosynthesis of fatty acids, biosynthesis of amino acids, and the starch synthesis. So here this is about the chemiosmotic hypothesis. Here the electron transports which are occurs on the membrane of thylakoids. So here some of the electron transport systems are the carriers which are located on the thylakoid membrane, or certain photosystems which are located on the thylakoid membrane. So here the PS2 cytochrome B6F complex and PS1. Already we know very well about the translocation of electrons or transportation of electrons from one carrier to another carrier. Already we discussed about the flow of electrons from one carrier to another carrier in the cyclic and non-cyclic photophosphorylation. So here in the Kemi-Asmadi hypothesis, the electrons which are released from the water molecule and enter into the PS2. The PS2 absorbs the sufficient energy from the sunlight and goes to excited state, but it transfers to the electrons, hydrogen carrier, but not to the electron acceptor. Then the hydrogen carrier, that is here the plastoquinone, transfers to the electrons plastoquinol, that is a reduced form of plastoquinone. Then the plastoquinol further transfers the electrons to the cytochrome B6F complex. For the continuous flow of electrons from plastoquinone to cytochrome BF6 complex, here the protons are translocated from stroma into the lumen of the thylakoids. So here, if you observe the stroma of the chloroplast, here low amount of H+ ion concentration is occurs and increases pH levels. But in the lumen of the thylakoid, here high amount of H+ ion concentration is occurs and decreases pH levels. So here the cytochrome B6F complex further transport electron to the plastocyanin, that is here copper containing mobile carrier, and further transfer to the PS1, then absorb the sufficient energy from the sunlight and goes to excited state and transfer its electron to the pyridoxine, and then pyridoxine transfer the electrons to the NADP+. Here the NADP+ is a final electron acceptor which is located on the outer surface of thylakoid membrane towards the stroma. So here for the reduction of NADP+, here the protons are also required, which obtained from the stroma. So here in the stroma, the H+ ion concentration decreases. So here the NADP+ further reduced into the NADPH+, by the enzyme NADP reductase. And then the proton gradient which is created in the lumen of the thylakoids and broken down by releasing of H+ ions from the lumen of thylakoid into the stroma. And then here certain amount of energy is released during the broken down proton gradient, that is here the PMF, proton motive force. Then the protons are translocated from lumen of the thylakoid into the stroma. So here the released energy PMF, proton motive force, can cause conformational changes in the CF1 component F1 of the ATP synthase. Then it has the catalytic activity, further it involved in the ATP synthesis from the ADP and inorganic phosphate. So here this is the Kemi-Asmadi hypothesis, and these are the four requirements for the Kemi-Asmadi hypothesis.